Now that my roof is complete, how do I use it to make an accurate estimate? Xactimate uses variables to represent the calculations for rooms without requiring you to do the math. When I add line items to this roof, variables are used to calculate quantities. When we use the term variables, we're usually referring to a measurement of a roof, such as squares, perimeter, or the eave lengths. When I open the properties window for the main roof here, you'll see at the bottom of this window a section titled Variables. Here is where you can see the applicable variables for the roof and sketch. You may have to click this button to expand the variables section. Some of the most common variables you use when estimating roofs are EAVE for the total eave edge length, P for the total roof perimeter, R for the total ridge length, SF for the surface area, SQ for the number of squares, and VAL for the total valley length. I'll show you an example of how these variables work. By viewing the SQ variable, I can see that this roof measures a little under 18 squares. If I add 3-tab 20-year composition shingles to this roof using the SQ variable as the quantity, Xactimate would add enough material to cover 18 squares of roof. Just like a room, if I were to change the size of my south overbuild from 22 to 29 feet, this would change some of the variables, like the perimeter, ridge, and squares. When we return to the properties window, I can see the change from a little under 18 squares to this current amount. I'm going to undo this change back to 22 feet. Don't forget, when calculating variables, a subgroup is considered part of the main roof. So any of these overbuilds, with a number in parentheses, is a subgroup, and therefore has its variables counted as part of the main roof's variables. If I wanted to see the squares of just the main roof without the overbuilds, I'd return to the properties window and select this Click for All Variables. A new window appears containing a description of all variables pertaining to the main roof, and it also shows the variable broken down into its main roof and subgroup. The main roof always has a zero after its variable, and each subgroup is numbered based on the number you see in parentheses after its name. I'll click the Close button when I'm finished with this window, and as usual, click away from the properties window to close it.
Did you like this video? We offer a variety of training options, including a course on sketching and estimating roofs in Xactimate. Just click the link in the description to find out more. Don't forget to like this video and hit the subscribe button for more of the latest Xactimate content.